Happy New Year to my wonderful subscribers. Thank you so much for all the support that you've shown to me throughout the past few months or so since I started my YouTube channel. I am truly, truly grateful to each and every one of you. I know I'm a little bit like a week late, but better late than never. I figured I'd just get it out of the way. So guys, I know I was supposed to do my 12 days to Christmas vlogmas. However, unfortunately, I had to put an end to that like really quick as soon as I started because I got really sick. And then I figured maybe after I got better in a couple days or so, I would try to play a catch up. Like, try my best to record the videos and catch up with the vlogmas. But that did not happen because afterward I needed some more rest and I figured, okay, it's important that I put my mental and, you know, physical health first. So what I'm posting here is just a simple compilation video of, it's really four videos really cut really short and bunched together of me doing a candle holder, a Christmas tree decoration, my birthday vlog, leave me alone, my birthday vlog, and what's the other video, Christmas tree decoration, oh, and cleaning by my grandmother's house. So I'm just putting them together, you know, just to get that out there still. Sorry I didn't get to complete my vlogmas video. Okay? So enjoy. Thank you so much again for almost 500 subscribers. And keep safe until I post my next video.
Okay, so guys, due to time and everything and that was catching up on me, I could not do a photo tutorial for my birthday. What happened was that I said I would just do snippets and little vlogs about vlog bits and pieces of what I was doing. So I basically drafted a basic bodice pattern down to the length of where I wanted the dress to be. And I cut that out, and then I went ahead and I also cut it out on the mesh fabric which I was going to use. I tried to get a mesh fabric that wouldn't like match my skin perfectly, so it'll give the illusion as if there's nothing there, but I couldn't get one to match my complexion the way I wanted, so I had to settle for this one, and it worked out pretty fine. Worked out well the seam.
This is what I was doing. So I cut out the mesh, and then now I'm applying, I'm using silicone glue. I'm applying the applique. So this is how the fabric actually comes. This, it's a white mesh on it, and I'm using this tool to cut out the applique. Once the appliques are cut out, I have a lot here, so it's hard to see, but once they're cut out, it would look like this. They have like different shapes. So what I'm just doing is trying to place it. This is my natural waist. So I was just trying to judge, just to cover up the areas here, you know? And I'll do the same for the back and the top part. I'll have to decide how I want that at them.
So guys, this is what I was saying earlier. Sorry about these angles, but this is a soldering machine that a wonderful friend gifted to me. See, it basically melts the mesh. So now I can get to cut out these patterns. I'm getting to cut out the patterns as I wish.
Here and I'm working. This is just what I used to stick on stuff. Like a metal sheet, and I just stick on whatever applique and pull it out. But this is what I have so far for the dress. Oh, paint my nails, paint my toenails, already done. But yes, I already stick on some applique. What I did, I put on the dress, so it's completely nude up here. Put on the dress, and then I tack one on two sides of these cups to see where my boobs, I would like them to have them covered. And I still have the entire back left to cover, and I'm going to do like a kind of design up here. So at this point I was almost completely fed up because I had to separate, because I already sewn the dress together, and I had to put like a barrier in between them, so when I'm sticking them on, because I don't have time to sew them on,
I'm just ready to go to bed, so I put just a sticky ribs bag in between there. I'm just gonna go in with these rest applique and stick them on as fast as I could and do the same thing, put it back. And guys, this is where I'm at. What I'm doing, I have these rhinestones and I've had them in a while, so I said I'm gonna start to stick on some of them on top of the dresses. Oh, this blur. Okay, there we go. See, I started sticking on some just randomly on top. This is what I have for rest. Okay guys, so this is what happened. I put a garbage bag underneath of it. Never mind the mannequin here. Boobs are there in my cup today. It's just that the mannequin is very small and the shoulders, the waist and everything is much shorter than mine. I have a longer torso. Yes, this is what happened. And I guys, it is about 6:20 a.m. I got up, I showered, and I'm gonna go and pick up my sister because we have to go and braid her hair. Oh my. Yes guys, I'll keep you updated. So guys, at this point, what happened was that I was supposed to have in some sort of a box braid style that I changed it to like an upstreet braided ponytail. However, my scalp is very tender, so it got kind of sore. So I ended up having to do like just a simple slick back ponytail and then attach like a braided ponytail to the end until my edges and my scalp healed a bit more, then I'll be able to braid my hair after. So these are just little snippets of me having my hair done. My birthday, she is shy. She didn't want her face showed. But yeah, she is very good. I've been going to her for years. Get braids done. This is actually the first time she's doing a ponytail for me. So I was very pleased with the end product. And for copyright purposes, I could not include all of these audios because, you know, music not belonging to me was playing in the background. This is us hurrying to get home so that we can get some rest and get ready for my night out. These are my nails. I did some press-ons and my toes. Toes were done by a professional nail tech, and this is how the dress looked on me the night I was feeling myself. I truly enjoyed my bread the night out. I had a blast. Welcome to the next video. So right now I'm just making a Christmas tree ornament. Originally I was going to make this ornament, but what happened was that as I was about to apply the hot glue, if you look closely, all this hot glue I'm applying to the bottom here to stick on the glitter foam, literally it fell from my hand and it attached to my middle finger on my left hand there. And oh my, when I'm telling you, like, this hurt is really, really hurt. As you can see the damage that it's done to my finger. I literally stopped doing it for a couple of days. And I was like, no. No more hot glue for a couple of days. So this is me starting over the entire Christmas tree ornament project. And this is the first time I'm actually trying out this kind. I wanted to do something fresh and new that I've never tried before. So yes. It's going to be a very, very short video, so you just go ahead and look along to what I am doing and you will get to see the end result in a bit. When I say I was scared to try this again because of the burn I already got on my finger, listen, I was so careful. I mean, I'm always trying my best to be careful, but that, you know, things happen sometimes that really scared me. But I determination came around and I said, okay, I'm gonna try this again because I really want to see how it's going to come out. Thank you. really pleased that I tried this again, because I'm so satisfied with the way that it came out. Look how cute this little gift box Christmas tree ornament is. And all I used was like glitter phone paper, a toilet paper roll, and a piece of a ribbon, a hot glue gun. That's all I did, really. So yes, I'm really pleased with the way it came out. Hope you guys try it sometime. So just dusting out and support, and yeah, gotta change the curtains, dusting off the chairs. Right now the cushions are outside, I guess it's in the sun, you know, and stuff like that. So yes, happy to be at Granny.
Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So for today's vlogmas, I'm just here at Mount Pleasant helping my grandmother with a little bit of Christmas tidying up for the season.
I have to change these curtains. Never mind how lovely they already are. And we, well, this section is already dealt with. Have the television. And we just have like the cushions and so forth. They're sunning right now to dust them out and so forth. So yeah, peep this lovely painting. Peep this lovely painting. Girl, that my mom did some years ago.
My grandmother is shy, she doesn't want to be in the video. But once we're finished and as we go along, I will show you guys little clips of what we're doing and when we're finished helping run it tidy up for today. And I know I haven't posted a video in a few days, but I've just been very, very busy. But I promise to try to keep up with the videos, okay?
The vinegar that Granny gave to us to wipe down her appliances and stuff, we're gonna mix it with some water, because you know you're not supposed to use all kinds of different chemicals on your appliances and so forth. They won't last long and they can bring forth rust. And with that, you can just add some dishwashing liquid. Yeah, this is where we're at so far. The curtains are down, the windows are wiped. Stuff, we just have to pack back all of this stuff, mop out and so forth, put up back these different curtains. If anyone's these gold curtains up this time. So yeah, we are getting there. We kind of put the cushions up already just for them to dry a bit, you know, more. Sun is very hot and vibrant today. You hiding? You hiding from the video? Let me show them you. Say hi. My cousin Raheem, who was helping to clean up the yard, is scrubbing down there. So you see things are going along. Well, we probably have plenty of flavor peppers out there, boy. We'll get two. Yeah, make sure y'all go to your grandparents' house and help them with their Christmas cleaning. Just a few days remaining. Help your elderly.
Yes.
Can't leave them too, because they're going to want to come to them and ask Granny how to bake bread. And Granny how to make cake. And Granny should not study because they didn't come help Granny to clean out for Christmas.
Duck spinner. Yes, so guys, this is the curtain that we're going to put up, and when we are finished, we will show you guys what they look like when they're up. So yeah,
more seconds.
Take a minute.
Yeah,
we should show you.
So at this point, my sister kept reminding me to take a video when we were finished doing the entire cleaning process of the living room and so forth. And she reminded me like 100 times, guys, and I still forgot because we had to like rush out of the house before it was too late to get home. But I asked my cousin Raheem to just film a quick video of what the place looked like after we left, and this is what we have. This is all he could have contributed for us, so yes. So guys, this is just a quick video of me doing a DIY candle holder using plastic spoons, you know, a little bit of spray paint, paper, glue gun, that kind of stuff. And I had some tea light candles for a while, so I said, I was doing some vases around Christmas time. I would try to complement at least one of the sets with this lovely candle holder. So yes. You can just go ahead and watch the video, follow along to what I'm doing. It's a really quick, short video. And I hope you try it out sometime and enjoy it. And let me know if I should be making these, like, in abundance to probably sell out some food if you guys are interested. Okay? Now, I know it's not the ending of the video yet, but as I said, it's a quick video. You can just watch along with what I'm doing and you'll be able to fully understand everything I'm doing. And guys, this is how it came out. It's so beautiful. I'm so pleased with the end product. Thank you so much if you stayed this far to watch my Vlogmas compilation. I am truly thankful. Thanks again for almost 500 subscribers, and I look forward to greater things for this year. Once in good health. Take care and enjoy.